Bakit ba natin ginugunita yung Semana Santa? Bakit may Holy Week? Of course, we know this is the death and the Sunday resurrection of Jesus Christ. So parang bookend siya ng salvation plan ni Jesus. Yung Christmas is the birth of His Son. Yung Easter po, okay, or yung Semana Santa na i-celebrate natin is the, of course, the death, but then hindi po natapos sa death, but the resurrection of Jesus Christ. The question, Maricel, is ba't ba kailangan bumaba ni Jesus, right, sa lupa para mamatay lang, di ba? Of course, si Jesus naman po, isa lang ang mission niya. He wants to personally deal with the issue of sin ng human being. Kailan ba pumasok yung sin? Of course, way back in the Garden of Eden, Adam and Eve, sabi sa Bible, through one man, sin entered the world. I could just imagine si Satan, dahil mabubulok siya sa impyerno and all, he's gonna experience eternal death. Baka naghanap ng damay, nalulungkot siguro, naghanap ng damay, na bola tong si Adam at Eve, and he knew, si Satan knew, pag sinuway ni Adam at ni Eve si God, death will follow. Okay? And we know the story, Adam and Eve allowed sin to enter the world, sabi sa Bible, because of that, lahat ng pinanganak after Adam and Eve have this inherent sin. Kaakibat po kasi ng kasalanan ay kamatayan. For the wages of sin is death, sabi lang po sa Bible. Okay, that's why this is very important na mula noon hanggang ngayon, after po, lahat ng pinanganak after Adam and Eve are tainted with what we call sin. Kaya po, I just wanna encourage everyone, sin is real, death is real, but then Jesus Christ came to deal with it personally. In Romans 3:23, sabi doon, for the wages of sin is death, okay? Ang kabayaran daw po ng kasalanan ay kamatayan. At paano ba hinarap ni Eva at Adan muna itong kasalanan na to? When they sin against God, una, they hide. Okay? They hid from God kasi nga, nahihiya sila because of the sin they committed, and that's the nature of sin. Meron pong shame na kaakibat ang sin. That's why, if I can plead with the people watching, talaga pong don't allow sin to enter any relationship, any whatever area of your life. Yung sin po talaga, it brings shame and guilt. And si Eva at Adan, the way they deal with sin, sabi sa Bible, they sewed fig leaves together and made coverings for themselves. Adam and Eve knew they've committed this terrible sin against God. And the way po nila hinarap yung kasalanan, tinakpan nila to by making a fig leaves. Kinover nila yung kahihiyan nila on their own to cover their shame and guilt with their own effort. And I think it's the same thing with us, ano? Tayo rin po, ginagaya natin yung ninuno natin si Eva at Adan. Every time we deal with sin, we're thinking by doing good works, we are actually covering our sin and guilt. And yun lang po yung warning, ngayong Semana Santa, we might end up doing a lot of good works, trying to cover our shame and our guilt. And we cannot pay for our sin by good works. Sabi nga po sa Bible, salvation is not a reward for the good things we have done. And sinabi rin po yung dahilan dyan, so that no one can boast before God. Again, Maricel and Ka-Orly, pag tayo po'y gumagawa ng kabutihan, thinking that it's a reward from God, it's a reward, okay? Yung salvation is a reward by doing good things. We are actually doing the opposite. Parang niyuyurakan natin yung ginawa ni Jesus sa krus ng Kalbaryo. When we try to save ourselves by good works, what we're saying is, God, parang hindi sapat yung pagkamatay mo sa krus. I'm gonna do my part. I'm gonna do good works to augment yung ginawa mo sa krus. That's what we're saying. Kinukutya natin yung ginawa ni Jesus. When we try to do what Adam and Eve did by covering our shame and guilt with our own. Kaya alam mo, Orly and Maricel, as I end, when Adam and Eve were cast down sa Garden of Eden, it's actually an act of grace because po yung puno, yung tree of eternal life, it's still there, sabi dun sa Bible. Pag kinain din nila yon, they will live in eternity with their sins. So even yung casting out of the Garden of Eden is an act of grace from God. That God didn't allow po na makagat nila yung isang puno pa, yung eternal life, because they're gonna end up throughout eternity, still in their sins. They were cast out of the Garden of Eden because of grace. And lastly, ito po yung another picture ng grace. Nung paalis na sila, sabi siguro ni God, but wait, yung tinahin nyo na dahon, mangungulunto yan, and every other week, tatahi ka na naman ng dahon to cover your shame and guilt. So God did something, and you might miss this out when you're reading your Bible, but this is very important. In Genesis 3:21, it says there, the Lord God made a garment of skin for Adam and Eve and clothed them. Okay? The other verse, Gerson, the Lord God made garments of skin for Adam and Eve and clothed them. Yan. Yan po ay napakagandang verse because God needed to kill an animal to have that garment of skin. He had to shed the blood of an animal, most likely a lamb, okay, to have that garment of skin to cover yung shame and guilt ni Adam. And actually, Maricel and Kaorli, it's a foreshadowing of what will happen at the cross. Fast forward thousands of years later, the perfect Lamb of God, Jesus Christ, will one day give His life by shedding His blood on the cross. Yan po ay foreshadowing that God did everything. In 2 Corinthians 5:21, as I end, God made Him who had no sin to be sin for us, okay, so that in Him we might become the righteousness of God. Yun lang po yung gusto ko sabihin sa mga nanonood. Si Jesus po was cursed at the cross so that we may be blessed. He died so that we may live. Kaya I just want to encourage everyone, katulad po namin ngayon, we're mourning for the death of our aunt. It's not the final destination. Death is just a start of eternal life. Those who have a relationship with Christ ay hindi po mamamatay na muli, bagkus mabubuhay throughout eternity. Kaya po, I just want to encourage you, it's a long explanation. It's supposed to be a 3-day seminar on theology, but I made it 5 minutes. So bear with me. Alam ko maraming questions sa mind nyo. But in a nutshell, the reason why we have this what we call Semana Santa, Holy Week, Jesus Christ personally dealt with our sin. Hindi po siya nagpadala ng angel to deal with our sin. He personally dealt with our sin. So that, just so you know na mahal tayo ng Diyos. He came so that we can be forgiven of our sin. Kaorli, masyado mahaba, maraming tanong sa isip ng karamihan. Pero I guess that's very important to understand. Mahal ka ng Diyos, yun lang yun. In a nutshell, mahal ka ng Diyos, you don't deserve to be saved. We all deserve hell, for the wages of our sin is death. And yet He chose to send His Son to die for you and me. That alone will give us hope in the midst of this pandemic. Maricel, Orly.
Maganda
Pastor
yung
Jeff, alam mo. Sige, go ahead ka, Orly.
Hindi, naalala ko lang kasi yung ano eh. For the wages of sin is death. Pero yung karugtong sa verse na yon, but the gift of God is eternal life. Yun ang
Amen.
Other side nun.
Yes, but that's for tomorrow.
Sorry. Pero na, that's for tomorrow, ka, Orly.
Pero anyway, Maricel, anong insight mo, yeah?
Mm-mm. Ang tumatak sa isip ko, Pastor Jeff, dun sa sinabi mo na you cannot pay for your sins by doing good things. Hindi ba? Pero of course, we're not saying that it's not good to do good things. Hindi ba?
Yes.
Pero yeah, yun talaga yung tumatak sa isip ko.
Maricel, good works is a fruit of your salvation, not the root of your salvation. It's not a means to an end. You can be saved by not doing good works. Because the man on the cross na kasama ni Jesus, nasa langit ngayon yon. I mean, he didn't do anything good. He's in heaven by virtue of grace. But good works will follow. Not a means to an end. It's just an overflowing gratitude of the grace you have received. Then good works is just a, you know, yun yung parang act of ano natin, gratitude natin.
Oh, totoo. Yun ang magandang nakuha ko, Pastor Jeff. Pero before anything else, Pastor, kami po ay nakikiramay, no. Alam ko marami sa atin talaga na nakaka-experience na we personally know yung mga tao na naapektuhan ng COVID. Ako, I personally know some of my friends who died because of COVID. I'm sure si Ka Orly meron din na kilala na mga kaibigan. So sana ayan tuloy, nagiging emotion aga-aga. Hindi, sana lang i-take advantage natin tong panahon na to para magnilay-nilay, especially with what's happening in our society right now. It's not just in the country, it's in the whole world. And
tama.
Hindi lang naman tayo, di ba lahat tayo nakaka-experience ng hirap because of this pandemic. So we shouldn't take this lightly. Yun lang.
Tama. Thank you.
Okay. On that note, maraming salamat, Pastor Jeff, and stay safe po.
Yes, thank you. Carlis, maraming salamat po sa pagkakataon. Again, this is your daily bread, your daily dose of inspiration. God bless you.
Thank you very much.